Hello everyone, my name is Kumar Aditya and in this video I will show you how to model a temperature dependent resistor in LTspice. So here on my screen I have created this voltage divider circuit in which I am using two resistors R1 and R3. So R3 is kept constant at 50 ohm and R1 I am modeling as a variable resistor, temperature dependent variable resistor. So for a positive temperature coefficient, we know that resistor value will increase with the rising temperature, and relationship between temperature and resistor is given by this classical formula, right? So RF is equal to R0 1 plus alpha delta T. So here RF would be the final value of resistor at the temperature of interest. R0 is the initial value of the resistor at some initial value of the temperature. Alpha is the temperature coefficient and delta T is change in temperature from its initial value. So R0 I have defined as RA in this simulation, and its initial value I have kept to be 50 ohm, same as R3. Alpha I have defined as TC, and its value I have used is 0.001, right? Usually value of temperature coefficient you can find in the data sheet of the resistor, and it's defined as ppm per degree Celsius, so parts per million per degree Celsius. So this ppm is 0.0001%, and for a precision resistor this value is very low, it's hardly 1 ppm. But in this simulation I have kept a relatively larger value so that you can see the effect of temperature rise on this resistor in a short simulation time. Now to model this delta T, I have created this thermal network. So this essentially R2 and C1 essentially model the thermal time constant of the circuit. This you can expand to model the thermal time constant of this particular resistor and the circuit on which this resistor has been included. So for example, this resistor could be mounted on a PCB, so you can expand the circuit to include the thermal time constant of that PCB as well. That PCB could be modeled on a heat sink, so you can expand this circuit to model the thermal time constant of the heat sink as well. So idea is that as the current flow, there will be power loss in this resistor, right? And due to the power loss, this temperature will increase. But temperature will not start increasing instantaneously, right? Because every circuit has its own time constant. So this R2 and C1 here model the thermal time constant of this circuit. Now again, I would repeat, this thermal time constant could be particular to this resistor. It could be modeled to include the effect of the PCB. It could be modeled to include the effect of the heat sink and so on. Now input of this thermal network or thermal circuit is the power loss in this resistor, and I am using this current source to calculate the power loss in this R1. So essentially I am taking the potential difference between this node and this node and multiplying it with the current flowing through the R1. So this node is N001 in this simulation, and this node I have labeled as out, and current I am measuring using this zero voltage source. So this voltage source has a value of 0 volt, so essentially it is acting as a current sensor. So here I have written this equation to measure the potential difference between two nodes in LTspice. You can simply write this command V, name of this node, whatever is the name, N001 or whatever is it in your circuit, comma whatever is the name of the second node. So this command will give you the potential difference between these two nodes. So multiplied by this current, I get the power loss. So this power loss I am feeding it into the thermal network, and on the other end of this thermal network I have the reference temperature, that is the initial temperature. So here I have kept it to be 25 degrees Celsius. Now these two nodes give me the junction temperature and the ambient temperature, and difference of these two nodes will give me the delta T, right? This delta T. So this delta T I have labeling as del T in this simulation, and I am using this behavior voltage source to take the difference of these two nodes. So here using this equation, and output of this behavior voltage source is my delta T, and this delta T I am calling it into this function here. So idea is that as delta T increases, value of this R1 should increase, given that this TC is positive. If TC is negative, this value of R should decrease. Now let's run the simulation. So if I run the simulation, on the top you see I am plotting output voltage. In the middle I am plotting the current through this R1, or this current ID, because you see ID, the same current is flowing through R1 and R3. There is no load on this voltage divider network, and V delta T is the voltage at this node. That is the temperature difference between the junction or the temperature of this resistor and the ambient temperature. So you can see here my delta T is increasing as during the initial stage of the simulation, and after a certain time interval it stabilizes, right? So this circuit has certain time constant. So during the transient phase we have the increase in temperature, and after its time constant, 5 times usually, it will reach its steady state. So this is what is happening. In the second plot, as the delta T is increasing, so this R1 will increase. So obviously this ID value will decrease. So we know that ID will be given by V1 times R1 plus R3. So since R1 is increasing, ID will decrease, and this is what we are getting here. Right now, as R3 increases, as R1 increases, V out will decrease, right? Because V out will be given by R3 divided by R1 plus R3. So as R1 is increasing, my V out is decreasing. So this is what is happening in the third plot or the top plot. So this essentially models the effect of temperature change on the resistor, and using this concept you can model a thermistor as well. You can model both NTC and PTC. Here I have used a simple fundamental equation. You can also model a complex equation to model the more accurate effect of the temperature. So I hope this idea will be useful to you in some way, and if you have any question you can leave that in the comment section.